All right, let me tell you something before we get started. Back in the old days, my family wasn't exactly thrilled about cameras. You pointed a lens at the wrong guy, that was it. You'd vanish faster than a cannoli at Uncle Vito's card game. So naturally, I go and build a camera box. This little pie camera's tiny, cute even, and in a dusty shop that's a death sentence. So I needed something to keep it safe. Something classy, but I'm getting ahead of myself. All right, let's back it up. Gotta keep dust off a tiny camera? I got a better way. Let me show you how I made this little box to do the job right. Alright, listen up, because I ain't seen this twice. For this little stunt we're pulling, we're keeping it classy. Cherry, curly maple. The kind of stuff you get from a sawyer who knows his wood like a bookie knows his clients. Beautiful stuff, don't disrespect it. And look at this. This tiny little camera. This thing says 64 megapixel like it's bragging about something, yeah? Well, it ain't got a protective lens, so guess who's making one? That's right, me. We slap on a step-up ring like we're teaching it manners. You want to live in my shop? You get protected, capiche? Now, check out this little tool here. This thing's gonna help me make box joints cleaner than a priest on Sunday. But first, everything gets cut to size. We're going quarter-inch box joints, which means the dado set's coming out. The old blade? Yeah, get lost. The dado? Front of the line like Uncle Tony at a buffet. Since I'm using the same thickness all around, bing bang boom, I set the blade once and we're cutting joints like we're running an assembly line in Brooklyn circa 1978. Snappy, fast, don't blink. Now, the real headache. The camera housing. The step-up lens wants a 1 5/8 inch opening, so we drill that out. We yank the camera out of the box. Look at this thing. I've seen meatballs bigger than this, but it fits. After we file out the corners like we're jailbreaking it. I'm making a plate to mount the camera to the box. The holes it came with are so small they're basically for looks. So we do it our way. I hog the walnut out with the router and creep up to the line with a chisel. Slow, careful, like defusing a bomb. And yeah, I chipped the edge. You see that? Good for you. It's going inside the box, nobody's gonna know. Now leather. Yeah, leather for the gasket. This'll keep the dust out, cause once fine dust gets on a lens, let me tell you, things start disappearing. Faces get fuzzy, details go missing. Muddier than a Bigfoot documentary. Bigfoot's always getting away. Funny how that is. We slice a little donut shape out of the leather so the lens sits snug. Like your pants after grandma's pasta. Before we mess with the leather, we gotta attach the piece that keeps the lens from making a run for it. We attach the screws like we're putting on cuffs. Then the leather donut and ring go on top, holding everything still, while we drill two more holes and pray that nothing gets any bright ideas. Now, we put on the lens. Cause even my camera's gotta wear eye protection in the shop. Accidents lead to questions. We don't need any questions. This is the smart part, the guts. Little green board. Don't ask me how it works, just respect it. Bottom of the camera gets this thing that keeps it from shaking. You attach this to the camera legs and it ain't moving. Nobody wants a blurry image. Blurry images are how Bigfoot keeps getting away with it. Bigger hole gets a threaded insert. The steady thing screws into that. But first I gotta put the insert in. Works real good if you use the drill press. I used to do it by hand, but that was like Pops coming home after a few with the boys. It never quite lined up. Guts go on the bottom piece. Just a few screws will keep it where it belongs. This little doohickey here, that's where the juice comes in. Now, the fun part, box joints. These things are magic. Nothing says good craftsmanship like a clean set of teeth that actually bite. They lock together, like Sunday dinner. Everybody's got a seat and nobody's leaving. Takes a little time to put it all together, but when it's done, it's a fortress. Check it for square. Here's a tip for you, straw cleans out glue like magic. Cut off the corner, use it like a scraper, like stirring mama's sauce, but sideways. While that dries, we make the lid. Now, this is where the box joints earn their keep. See, everything's already square. Everything already knows where it goes, so I can use the box itself as a pattern and mark the lid exactly where it needs to land. And yeah, you'll notice the gaps. Relax, wood wants to breathe and expand. It wants to move around a little and live its wooden life. Those gaps, they're supposed to be there. Problem is, gaps invite dust, and keeping dust out is why we're making this box. So we had ledges on the inside, a little glue and a few pieces, a handful of clamps, forget it. Now, I finished the edges. Clean them up, knock the sharp off so it feels right in the hand, like it belongs there. I thought I'd be smart and do some angled edges. Chamfers is what they call them. Everything was looking good, until it wasn't. So I take it to the sander and round it over slow. Cherry and hard maple are looking for a reason to burn. Give them one, they'll take two. Now, it's time to finish the gluing and attach the base. You ready for this? Listen up, you're gonna love this. You hear that pop? That sound means the wire is going to stay put when it's plugged in. If it slides on quiet, I don't trust it. Now I just knock off the bottom edge. Keeps it clean, keeps it honest. That's it. Time to scrape the hole outside with a card scraper. I love these things. They pull grain out like a confession from a guilty man. Now I want to screw the lid on. Problem is those ledges are skinny, like they've been skipping dinner. So I angle the screws in. Shim on the drill press. Smart. Yeah. Now it's time to put Humpty Dumpty back together. Camera goes on the front, computer spaghetti goes into the guts. Real gentle. This ain't angel hair, it's more like wet lasagna. Boom. You got yourself a handmade wooden camera box that looks like it was built by a lunatic craftsman with too much coffee and not enough supervision. Alright, now here's where it gets fun. My nephew Sam, smart kid, real nerdy type. He cooked up this little program for this thing. Don't ask me how, I just nod. Besides being a camera, it makes something I can connect to with my phone. Little website pops up, shows me exactly what the camera sees. That's as much as I need to know. I lock in what I want the camera to see. Then I can tweak things. How sharp, how bright, no Bigfoot blur. Once it looks right, I hit the button and it starts taking pictures. Today I figured I'd do something different. Moving pictures of ice melting. Bowl full of ice. Camera on the tripod, plug it in. I move it till it looks good, and we're taking pictures. That's it. A tiny camera, a clean box, and a setup that just works. Because when the thing you don't have doesn't exist, you make it. Make your own solutions, break your own habits, keep making things.